Make sure you save your land surveying data well, quick and easy. I'm Hanno from MGLOS and today I will tell you about saving your land surveying data to TXF so that you can use it in AutoCAD, MicroStation or any other CAD software. In this playlist about the easy to use land survey app for Android, I explained before about how you can map or land survey different objects like lines, points and areas. But of course, after mapping those objects, you want to store the data of those objects. One of the most common file types to save this data is in DXF. As you can see on the screen of AppGloss Survey Wizard, I have mapped some objects and I want to save them in a DXF file format. To do so, I go to the file menu. The drop-down menu appears. To save the data to a DXF, you click on the option Save and a new screen appears. The first thing you do is select the file format. To save the data into a DXF, you set this option to DXF. The screen changes with options to save a DXF. Then you check if the correct coordinate reference system is selected. If it's not, then you click on the cancel button and you configure this land survey app for Android with the correct coordinate reference system. In this video, on the top right, I explained how to configure the coordinate reference system. In my case, the coordinate reference system is OK. Then we need to select the folder where we save the DXF file. So I click next to the folder icon. Here I go to the folder that I want to save the DXF file in. And then I click on the button Select. On the saving screen, you see now the chosen folder next to the folder icon. Now we need to give the file a name. To do so, we click on the space next to the ID card icon. In the new screen, we fill in the name. And when the name is completely filled in, you click on the OK button. If you want to share the DXF file immediately, then you turn on the checkbox next to the airplane. After saving the file, Android will show you some options to share the file. This depends on the apps that are installed on your Android device. In my case, I leave this option unchecked. Then you can choose if you want to save the DXF in 2D or 3D. When you save the DXF in 2D, then all objects will be saved with the same Z value of 0. The mapped heights will still be mentioned in the blocks that AppGloss Survey Wizard creates in the DXF file, so no data will be lost. In my case, I will choose 2D. After that, you can select the units that you want to save the DXF file in. You can select meters or feet or inches. There are many options. I choose meters. AppGloss Survey Wizard saves all points with some extra information. This information is put in different layers in the DXF file. Standard, those layers are turned invisible in the DXF file. That means that they are there but not seen immediately when you open the DXF file. Of course, in a CAD program, you can turn the layers visible again. So the information that AppGloss Survey Wizard puts in the DXF file is the point number. When you want to have the point numbers immediately visible, then you check this checkbox. Another thing that AppGloss Survey Wizard says in the DXF file is the deviation that the GNS receiver mentions when the point gets mapped with this land survey app for Android. With that information, you can always see how accurate the point was mapped and if it's accurate enough for the purpose you want to use it for. When you want to see those deviations immediately in the DXF, then you check this checkbox. I leave both checkboxes unchecked to keep a better overview in the DXF. After doing all this, then you only need to click on the OK button to save the file. After doing that, all data gets saved in the DXF file. And now we saved the file. That was easy, right? If you agree, then give this video a like. If you want to make a DXF of your property, then also check out this video on how to measure your property. Thanks for watching and enjoy using AppGloss Survey Wizard.